Welcome to Guitar Technique Episode 6, Accuracy Drills to Perfect Picking. Well, you know, guitar players will often become incredibly frustrated by missed notes and flubbed pick movements that'll tend to, you know, accidentally connect into a wrong guitar string. It can be really annoying when it happens, especially when you're trying to play some guitar part as best as possible. You know, if you're trying to record or something, it just can drive you nuts. But if you are doing that, you know, if you're missing notes and your phrases are, you know, becoming terrible because they're falling apart due to poor technique, it can certainly make you feel really upset. So in this episode of Guitar Technique, what we're going to do is work through a collection of drills that are going to help you and your picking hand become a lot more focused with what you're doing. And if you practice these drills for about 3 weeks, you know, that old 21 days rule, they're going to help you to really start to feel a much better connection to performing picked melody lines on guitar a lot more accurately. So anyway, let's get things started with part one of the lesson. In exercise 1A, we're going to be working through a two-string parallel 16th note drill. And how this is going to operate is we're going to start it where it's written in the handout, and then we're going to move it all around the guitar neck a little bit and give you a good idea on how you can kind of make it more mobile. Now, first of all, starting off on this thing, it's a pattern that's going to be working from the handout. If you look at the tab, it's going to be on the first and second guitar strings, and we're going to be operating from the 8th fret to 5th fret on the first string, and then the 6th fret to the 5th fret on the second string. And that takes care of the first two beats of the exercise. Then what's going to happen next is we're going to move to a different note selections within the same region. We're going to have on the first string 6-5, and then we're going to have 8-5 on the second string. And that takes place on the third and fourth beats. So when you put the two of them together, you get this. So it's, you know, it's a pattern that's happening between the notes. Now, I would, of course, you know, memorize it first, and then when you feel ready, turn a metronome on something, you know, at a manageable pace. This is 16th notes, so you may want to start a little slower. I'm going to start at 80. That's what I'm going to have my pulse set at here. So get in tune with that click. If you have to, take one note. Remember, it's a 16th note study, so maybe play one note. 1E and a 2E and a 3E and a 4E and a, you know, get right in the check with the beat there. And then you can start moving through the exercise if it feels comfortable. Check it out. 2, 3E and a, 4E and a. And then when you feel ready, crank the metronome up a little bit. You know, here it is at 96, 2, 3, 4. And the goal tempo, if you look at the page, the goal tempo is 110 beats per minute. That's clipping along pretty fast there. So make sure you're ready before you go into that. You don't want to play it sloppy. Okay, count it in. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so when you feel ready, take it up to that kind of a pace. Now, the next thing is to move it around. So we've been doing it where it's written in the handout, but you know, you could take it any place. You could maybe even just start simple and transfer it over a couple strings. Maybe, in my case, maybe what I'll do here is take it between the third string to the fourth string. So again, same pattern outline, starting with the 8-5, 6-5 like that, then go in reverse 6-5, 8-5. Always go slowly. You know, make sure your rate and pace that you're studying at is exactly what you can play things at perfectly. And then when you feel ready, you know, you could turn your metronome on at whatever pace feels comfortable. You know, move it around or whatever. I think it's really important that you get up to a level of playing where you feel comfortable. We could just sort of jump into the idea that you're working on as an exercise. If you can't do that, start slower, go at it a little bit more without a metronome on, and then slowly get your, you know, rate and pace built up to a decent level. But again, the golden rule with technique exercises is use a metronome and never play faster than you can play that exercise perfectly, because you will burn in bad playing just as easy as you'll get good playing in there. So remember that. It's super valuable to understand that. But you know, over time, move this exercise all over the neck. You could take it real low down here if you wanted to. You could take it up higher, maybe around, you know, 12th position or something. You could do it up here, you know. everywhere you play an exercise on the guitar fingerboard, you know, it feels different. The distance from your fingertips of the fretting hand to your guitar pick is the distance is different. So it feels different again. String action is different if you're here as opposed to there. The span of the frets, how wide the frets are apart, from the steel fret wires. They're wider apart here than they are in the middle, and then it's very small when you get into the higher region. So all this stuff makes a difference technically. So when you get an exercise like we have here in exercise 1A, you want to learn how to move it all around the neck. So start working on this one, get it into your playing. We're going to take a short break and come back in a moment with exercise 1B. That's an excerpt from the sixth lesson of my guitar technique course. The remainder of this lesson is available behind a paywall on my website at creativeguitarstudio.com, but I thought you'd like to see this segment, so I put it on YouTube for you to get an idea about what this guitar technique course has to offer. If you want to subscribe to my website and gain access to this course along with my introductory, intermediate, and advanced guitar programs, plus many other guitar courses on the site, just head over to creativeguitarstudio.com and sign up with a free membership to get yourself started, and then you can always upgrade to either a monthly or you could go for the discounted yearly membership plan. Just click on the link in the YouTube description box under where it says Become a Member Today. If you want to learn the modes and get a really good understanding for how they can be used musically to write songs, play a solo, or compose melody lines, then you're in luck. My ebook, Using the Major Scale Modes, is a comprehensive manuscript outlining exactly how modes are used in respect to harmony and to compose or improvise melodic ideas. Over 50 pages of scale patterns, example progressions, and music theory all come together to create a comprehensive method on how to use the modes that's easy to understand. Using the Major Scale Modes is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Thanks for watching the lesson. Be sure to sign up for a membership at creativeguitarstudio.com to watch part two. In part two, we'll study more drills on two and also on four string picking, and we'll study six string multi-position arpeggios. Plus, as a member, you'll also be able to download the handout for this lesson along with many more guitar lessons. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch up again in the members area.